The £12 billion Transpennine Route Upgrade, or TRU, promises to deliver a step-change in capacity, make journeys greener, and speed up east-west rail journeys across the Pennines. But despite the scale of the project, I imagine many people haven't heard about it, let alone appreciate what the project entails. In many ways, the project has been overshadowed by HS2 and to some extent East-West Rail. But the project is no less important. This is the first time I've covered the project, which is more local to me than East-West Rail, but up until now, there hasn't been much to see in terms of big civil engineering, and I don't think that footage of miles of overhead wires would make for a particularly engaging video. Now though, shovels are well and truly in the ground, and work on some of the bigger civils works has begun. That's not to say there haven't been tangible signs that work has been underway, and some key objectives are almost complete, such as the electrification of a 13km section of the line between Manchester Victoria and Stalybridge. Work on this section has been underway for almost 3 years, and has involved rebuilding bridges, upgrading track and signalling, and installing overhead line equipment, or OLE, between Manchester and Stalybridge. It is now possible to see the culmination of this work, although I imagine the average commuter wouldn't give it a second thought. The wires were energised and the first electric test train ran this week, which marks the start of the testing phase on this section. Once fully commissioned towards the end of this year, Transpennine Express trains will be able to travel from Liverpool to Stalybridge under electric power for the first time. Currently, the Class 802 bi-mode multiple units have to switch from 25kV overhead wires to diesel at Manchester Victoria before heading east. I plan to release a more detailed video about those units in future, so be sure to keep an eye out for that. Electrification from Manchester Victoria to Stalybridge will be one of the first large-scale projects delivered as part of the TRU, but the scale and scope of the project stretches all the way to the East Coast mainline. Travelling east across the Pennines, it's possible to see signs of construction right across the route, with work sites and plant machinery visible across much of the 100km route. The easternmost section of the upgrade involves electrifying and upgrading the section of track between Church Fenton and Colton Junction on the East Coast mainline, with wires expected to go live imminently. Eventually, the 41km section of railway between Leeds and York will be upgraded and electrified, which involves adjusting existing bridges and removal of level crossings. Heading back west, one of the more apparent upgrades has already been completed, with Moy Station now having been rebuilt. A new, fully accessible two-platform station, which can accommodate 6-car trains, is nearing completion. The station is open, but when I visited, the last few finishing touches were still being completed.
Doors opening.
The station has in fact been moved eastwards, and it's possible to see much of the old platform on the eastbound side of the railway, still in situ. For a simple and functional station, it actually looks quite nice, and I like the brick cladding around the lift shafts. But more importantly, at least in terms of the TRU, is the overbridge connecting the two platforms has been built high enough to allow 25kV overhead wires to be installed underneath. Wires will eventually be installed from Stalybridge to Leeds, so therefore much of the TRU will be focused on adjusting overbridges to accommodate the OLE. The station upgrades between Stalybridge and Huddersfield are relatively straightforward, but the upgrade of Huddersfield and the stations between there and Ravensthorpe will be more involved, as not only will the line be electrified, but the number of tracks will be doubled from 2 to 4. Huddersfield to Ravensthorpe will be the subject of my next video, in which I'll talk in more detail about those plans. The upgrade of Huddersfield station is about to get underway, and the first signs of work were visible during my visit. Upgrading a 176-year-old Grade 1 listed station will of course be a challenge, but much of the work will take place on the station side, with the neoclassical frontage remaining unchanged. The roof will however be sympathetically restored, and two new through platforms on the northern side will be constructed. In addition, a new footbridge and lifts will be installed, providing step-free access from the front entrance, and the existing underpass will be lengthened to serve the new platforms. The track and signalling will also be upgraded to provide capacity for more trains, as well as work to allow for the electrification of the route, which will include installing OLE within the station. Electrification is a key part of the TRU, but running electric trains alone will not provide the step change in capacity promised. For that, a more radical solution is needed, which will be the subject of the next video. Be sure to subscribe and hit the notification bell so you don't miss that video. And just before I sign off, I'd like to say a big thank you to my Patreon and YouTube members who helped make videos like this possible. If you'd like to consider supporting the channel, there'll be links in the description below, or if you're watching on a TV, search Rail Focus Patreon on Google.